What's up, tennis fans? I'm Lauren Lynch, and this is Tennis Now, your source for the latest tennis news now. John Isner starred in the longest saga in tennis history and looks like a man in dire need of a stunt double in making the fastest exit of Wimbledon's men's draw today. The day after, an inspired Isner drove himself into tennis history with an 11-hour, 5-minute victory over Nicolas Mahut, he was running on empty against Thiemmo De Bakker. An exhausted Isner lost 8 straight games to open the match and never found his footing or his serve in falling in 1 hour and 14 minutes. The big man went to major extremes in winning the longest match in tennis history yesterday and losing the shortest men's match of the fortnight today. I was on low fuel out there and didn't really have a chance, said Isner, who lost the opening set in 16 minutes. It wasn't like I was dying out there, I was just tired. Sometimes the adrenaline can take over, but that wasn't the case today. I've never been this exhausted before, but it still stinks to lose in the second round. Playing with blisters on both feet, a stiff neck, and a sore right shoulder, Isner was no match for the 2006 Wimbledon Junior Champion, who said he felt sorry for Isner. 70-68, I mean, it's pretty sick, De Bakker said. It's tough because you know he's struggling. It was a fast finishing Friday of play on the ladies' side. Venus Williams, Kim Clijsters, Justine Henin, and Yelena Yankovic were among the former world number one women who reached the fourth round as all 8 women's singles matches were decided in straight sets. Henin and Clijsters both beat Russian opponents to set up a blockbuster fourth round showdown on Monday between the Belgian rivals. It will be their 25th career clash, with the rivalry deadlocked at 12 wins apiece. Clijsters, who won their 2 meetings this season, both in third set tiebreakers, Henin has also been better in their Grand Slam encounters, posting a 5-2 record in major meetings, including victories in the 2003 French Open Final, 2003 US Open Final, and the 2004 Australian Open Final. Now, there was a time when the two were hardly the best of friends, and their camps sniped at each other on occasion. But both said they've grown older and spent time as teammates, and their relationship has improved. Our relationship is very good, Henin said after her win over Nadia Petrova. We feel we grew up a lot, both of us. We have a lot of respect, so of course on the court, we both want to win, but the relationship is very good. Clijster said, I think we've had great times together playing Fed Cup and just messaging each other on the phones, teasing each other, fun, you know. I think that's how I would have liked it to have always been. Venus Williams did doubles duty today. The 5-time singles champion beat Alyssa Klebanova in singles, then partnered with her sister Serena to win a second round doubles match. Both Venus and Serena, who hold all 4 Grand Slam doubles titles, are seeing double vision when it comes to winning Wimbledon. We are here for the title, Venus said. We're just trying to win in the doubles and singles. Venus celebrated her 30th birthday last week and is not considering slowing down anytime soon. People are playing longer these days. They don't give it up too quickly anymore. If they do give it up, they come back and keep winning, Venus said. Well, for more information, make sure to log into Tennis Now and follow us on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. That wraps us up for today. I'm Lauren Linton, this is Tennis Now. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.